Lightning poses a risk to our lives and our homes, but researchers are working on new ways to draw the dangerous strikes away from tall buildings and populated areas. Meteorologist Addis Uklo explains how lasers could someday help protect us.
All of a sudden, I smelt something, the smell of electrical wire burning.
For Julie Baruchman, a lightning strike sparked the flames that gutted her house last summer. And just 2 weeks ago, lightning did this, shooting through the walls of a Brookline home.
It was really scary. I've never seen anything. It was so loud.
Lightning occurs when electrical charges separate. A weak spot electrically is created in the atmosphere. Then lightning can strike a target, like a house or a stadium. Researchers have successfully used a high-powered laser to artificially create a weak spot in the atmosphere. They directed the lightning toward a preferred target, like a lightning rod. Jean-Pierre Wolf is a professor at the University of Geneva and part of the research team that did this, guided lightning with a laser at a telecommunications tower on top of a Swiss mountain.
So I could really see the lightning following the laser beam.
Morris Cohen, an associate professor at Georgia Tech, says the laser heats up the air, creating a little tunnel for lightning.
What the laser can do is it can create a slight weak spot. And as the natural lightning is coming through, it's going to prefer to go through that weak spot.
Researchers believe lasers someday could be used to protect launch pads, nuclear power plants, stadiums, and airports.
Lightning striking near an airport is one of the big reasons why aviation is shut down in the context of thunderstorms.
In fact, a lightning strike 3 years ago at Pittsburgh International Airport created a 3-foot by 5-foot hole in a concrete runway.
We were kind of scratching our heads because there's a lot of little taxiway lights all the way around that are metal. You know, you'd think it would go for that first.
Trudy Scherzer is the operations duty manager at Pittsburgh International.
Whenever there is lightning, we have a lot of protocols in place to make sure that everybody's safe.
Scherzer and her team monitor quickly changing summer conditions using a high-tech satellite-based computer that detects lightning strikes in the area and a color-coded warning system.
Once we get to a yellow, that is more of a cautionary stage. Lightning is struck within 12 and a half to 15 miles of the airport.
When lightning is within 5 miles of the airport, it's stage red. All pre-flight operations cease and all ground crews take cover. But would lasers potentially have a role in safety here?
Obviously, as long as it gets approved by the FAA and everything like that. But I think it's wonderful that they're trying to be innovative and come up with some new way to prevent lightning strikes.
The researchers say that's a few years away. There's much more work to be done before lasers can be ready for commercial use.
But until you make something compact, reliable, cost-effective, you probably require 5 years.
I think it would be a tremendous benefit. I mean, it could be a lifesaver.
Addis Uklo, Channel 11 News.
All right, Addis, thank you. Well, Professor Wolf says if they can bring down the cost of the lasers potentially could also be used to help prevent forest fires sparked by lightning.